So good morning one and all. Today we'll start up with the remaining portion related to our module 5, so which is building, product building and structures. So until now we have studied what do you mean by product building, how do you develop with the help of virtual environment, product development virtually, the tools, the techniques, the methodologies, and also we studied about what do you mean by a structure, product structure, how do you visualize a product structural view, all the four types of structures, and how you conclude and product structure matrix, right? So all these things we studied, and also we studied about some of the modeling aspects. So how does the modeling process influence our product development structures? So after doing this, we also studied about digital mock-up, all those stuff. So now we have to deal with what do you mean exactly by data modeling. So anyone, if you haven't written the name in the chat room, kindly type it out. I will just take the screen sheet after some time. So the attendance should tally both in the chat room as well as in the screenshot. Okay, so I'll share the PPT right away. Right, so we were dealing about the modeling process also in the last class. After that, I told today we will be dealing related to what do you mean by data modeling. Once you are aware with the product structure, product structural view, and how the modeling process in a product structure takes place, you will be having the main activities, it will be bifurcated into sub activities, it will be decomposed with respect to the description of the work. So this is the actual modeling process which takes place in any product structure which is structurized positively and successfully. So after understanding the modeling process, you should now know what you mean by data modeling. So data modeling is nothing but the process of creating a data model for the data which is stored in the database. Okay, so usually we have the database in which the data will be stored, right? So similarly, for the data which is being stored will be professionalized by creating certain models, and we call that as an data modeling. So this data model figures out a conceptual representation of the data objects what you have. This is similar to that of the design, conceptual design. So before going into the actual design, you just lay out a conceptual figure. How does the product looks like? Similarly, here also it helps to figure out a conceptual representation of the data objects which is in need. So this is the main agenda or the goal of the data modeling part. So this also helps in visual representation of data, and it enforces a set of rules and regulations with respect to the regulatory compliances and government policies. So every norms to be followed associated with an individual product also will be embedded in the data modeling. Okay, so this provides an actual conceptual representation right from the beginning, all the documentation parts associated from the beginning till the end. So you have to follow n number of rules and regulations with respect to the government authority board as well. So all the forms, regulations, what we have to follow right from initiation stage to the decline stage and auditing of the product, everything will be embedded in this data modeling. So it figure out some conceptual representation of all the data objects which is associated. And hence, data model ensures consistency in naming conventions, okay, the default values, the semantics and the securities, everything what we have to follow. So it provides an A to Z information regarding the product which has to be manufactured. And also, it helps in organizing the entire data which is in need when it has to be used in doing n number of operations. Every product will undergo n number of operations in order to manufacture the part and get assembled it. So all these data will be emphasized in our data modeling. And it is almost similar to that of the architect's building plan. So architect's building plan will provide first and conceptual model. If he is constructing a new innovative type of a house or any company or an industry, he will first sketch and show how does the outer view of an industry, a company or a house looks like. So that is called as the conceptual design. It will be exactly similar to that which is associated with the data objects. So it figures out a conceptual representation of the actual data objects which is in need right from the beginning to the end. So these were the description related to what you mean by data modeling. So next you should know what are the goals associated with the data model. So the goals which are associated are, it helps in obtaining an accurate representation of the data base. So it will be updated. It is not like outdated data what you are associating. It will be the updated data and the accurate data so one can relay on it directly. So this is the main agenda or the goal of using an data model. So what does it do? It helps in omission of the data which lead to creation of faulty reports and produce incorrect results. So no data will be associated in the data model which will lead for an faulty report or which will yield to an incorrect results, because every data here will be cross-checked accurately so that you will end up with an correct result of the product and no faulty reports will be associated, because this will be omitted right away in the data model. So next goal is, a data model helps to design the database at conceptual level, physical level and logical level. So these three are categories of the data model. So we will go into this in depth later. Okay, so this helps to figure out the database in all the levels. Okay, so we will go back to this later. Next, a data model structure helps to define relational tables, primary and foreign keys and stored procedures. So you will be having associated tables of the data which will be relational, so you can change, you can edit and modify. If you modify one table, that will be reflected in the others because all the tables associated will be interrelated. Okay, so it will be functionalized by using primary and the foreign keys as well. So this is one of the good plus point in our data model. And next, it also provides a clear picture of the base data and it can check how the developers use the database to create the physical database. So in order to create a physical database, you need an data model developer. See, he will use the initial database at the conceptual level in order to originate the database at the physical level. So this is also one of the goal of the data model. And this data model also helps in identifying the missing and the redundant data associated with it. Okay, so when you are performing some product design and you need some data if it is not there at your level, so if you use the data modeling, if you access it, you can get the missing data or any redundant data associated to your particular product. So this is one of the goals. And next, though the initial creation of data model is labor and time consuming, in the longer run if you go, it helps your IT infrastructure to upgrade and also to achieve maintenance at a cheaper rate and at the faster level. This is what you understand as, initially to create the data model, it is very much of time consuming. So once you achieve with this data model, so it for a longer run, it helps to upgrade your IT infrastructure. Okay, so when you're updating the IT infrastructure with respect to data model periodically, so if any new design you want to do it also, you'll be having a huge data package data stuffs, data models and relationship models and tables associated, and developers to interlink from conceptual to that of the physical database. So it will be very in ease to access the material and to create your product design, check the prototype virtually, and then coming for the actual manufacturing. So it helps to upgrade and run new innovative products at a faster rate. And also maintenance will be ease and cheaper, because all you are accessing accurate database, so that you yield in good results, and maintenance will be sufficiently less, and it will be cheaper also, and it could be done at a faster rate. So these are the goals of using a data model. So after knowing what you mean by data model, what is the goals associated with it, you should understand the types of data models. So here in the goals also it is mentioned, it helps in designing the database at these three levels. So these three levels are now what we are dealing with. So one is the conceptual, the second is the logical, and the third is the physical model. So what happens in case of conceptual model? So this data model defines what the system exactly contains. It will identify the product what we have to manufacture, so that particular system, what it contains exactly. So after understanding what it contains, so this model is typically created usually by the business stakeholders and the data architects. So conceptual model is always created by the data architect as well as the business stakeholders. So they will, it will help them to identify the conceptual data model, which is the beginning initial level, which has to be taken care by the business stakeholders to survey how the market is, what the need is, and what the product you are going to manufacture. Is it feasible? And if it is feasible, what are the data you have associated with it? You should even have the survey data from the market level, from the customer level, from the material level, from the vendor level, from the transportation level, service, maintainability, rules and regulations from the government bodies. So all these have to be checked by the business stakeholders. Similarly, if it comes to the architect field, the data architect person will develop the conceptual design for the particular project what he is taking care. So all this conceptual concept of data model will be done in the conceptual level. So the main purpose of this level is to organize, scope and define the business concepts exactly as per the goals and objective of the company. And as per the norms, they have to check as per the rules and regulation, is it applicable, feasible and economical. So all these things will be checked in conceptual level. So next comes our logical level. So what happens in the logical level? So it defines how the system should be implemented regardless of our database management system. Okay. So how the system should be implemented. So you have your database models now. So without the intervention of the database model, how exactly the system should run, how it has to be implemented. So that will be taken care, because logical. So once you define the conceptual data model, that should be feasible and applicable in reality. So in order to check in reality whether it works, the logical level will interrelate the practical requirement and is it tallying with that of the conceptual data model which is being developed by the business stakeholders and the data architects. So it is in comparison of the virtual thing with that of in reality whether it will be feasible, and hence it is called as logical. You can also think that as, is it sensible enough? The conceptual data generated, is it sensible and is it practically applicable? So that will be checked in logical level. And then comes the physical level. So what happens here? This data model will describe how the system will be implemented using a specific DBMS system. So now once it is logical, once it is proved, it is logical. So then it shows in exactly how this data model will be used or implemented in actual to see how the product looks like. So this is usually created by the DBA, the people, database analyst and product developers. Okay, so the main purpose is actual implementation of the database. So the conceptual database which is created will be sensed and checked to see it is logical. Once it is approved, it is logical, then it will be implemented in actual. Okay, so then you will be able to visualize all the database which has been generated related to that particular product. So these are about the types of the data model. So let me take a screenshot of it. Anyone, if you haven't written your name and USN, kindly type it out. Yeah. So now we understood the types of data model, what do you mean by data model, and the goals associated. So if they ask you in the examination to explain the data models related to your product structures, so you should be able to describe what it is and also show the diagram. Okay, how does it look like? So these are the three levels. One is the logical, physical, and the create your update level. So which is similar to it. Conceptual, logical, and physical. Okay, so you will show the three data models. So you have to see how it has been interrelated. So first one is the create update data. So which is nothing but our conceptual. Okay, so then comes the logical and then the physical. You should see how it is interrelated. Okay, so in order to update the data, so you will get the actual business data. So it will be created, and once it is approved logically, so these data will be visible for the access. And then comes the logical data. Okay, in logical data, all the process models which are in need, all the data which are in need will be embedded, and it will be checked logically whether the process models which has been defined, whether the data requirement is sufficient or not to run the different models will be tested logically. So once the data which has been generated could be implemented successfully in reality, then logical data will provide the acceptance model, and this logical data model will be generated. So once this is generated, it will be transferred to our physical data modeling, because here it is the actual implementation of the data model once the acceptance is received from the logical data. So it transfers the logical data model to physical data modeling. So for the approval, it also needs the technical requirements and the performance requirements. So that will be embedded to the physical data modeling sector. So with the help of the requirements, it will check whether the given logical data model is mapping or not. If it is mapping, then it provides an acceptance for the implementation of this database physically. So once this acceptance is done, it will generate the physical model. So once the physical model is done, it will be coming back to the data which has been updated initially in the conceptual one to update the data which has been developed. So every time the data developed will be given back to the conceptual level in order to update it record related to the business data. Because every time the company will be generating one or the other innovative product. So it should be having the database associated with all these products. So even the physical data model which is generated will be stored in our conceptual database for the future requirement. So this is how the data model runs in a particular product structure. Okay, so you should draw the diagram, explain its objectives, goals, everything related to data model. So after knowing how does it work, the goals, the objectives, you should also know what are its plus points and the drawbacks. So what are its first for plus points or the advantages? I told you already, it omits all the irrelevant rules, formalities and documentation. So it won't yield with a bad result. It yields with a good result because it is showing the approval and acceptance of the data which are very accurate. So one advantage is that it helps in getting an accurate data model. So this is one of the plus points. So the goal of the data model is to make certain that data objects offered by the functional structure will represent accurately because they omit the data which is not needed and which will result in the bad results. As a result, you get all the data associated very accurately, precisely, and it yields in a good efficient result. The second advantage is the data model should be detailed enough to be used for building the physical database. So this is the advantage of data model is the data what you generated in the conceptual level will be sufficient enough in order to implement this database physically. So this is the second advantage. The information in the data model can be used for defining the relationship between the tables. I told here already, you will be having the database in the tables and all these tables will be interrelated. So this is one more plus point. So the data accumulated in the data model could be used for defining the relationship between the tables which are associated, with the help of using the primary keys and the foreign keys, and also following some procedures which are there associated with how the data are stored. So there will be some functional keys, primary keys. So by pressing and using those keys, you can get a relation between the tables associated in the data model. So this is one of the advantage. Next is, data model also helps in business to communicate within and across the organization because the data which has been generated could be used within a company by many people, different teams who are working in different products who are in need with the data models for different purpose. So it helps in building and communication in between the different teams who are working in different area. Right, so this is one of the plus point. Next is the data model helps to document the data mapping in ETL process. I told you this is in ETL process. So finally the physical data model is generated, will be updated back to our conceptual data model. So it helps in mapping the documentation which is being generated with the help of ETL process. So this is one of the advantage. Lastly, it helps to recognize correct source of data to populate the model. So you have to populate the model exactly. How you populate the model? By using or generating the product modeling, right? So in order to develop the modeling process of a product, you should be having some data. So this data population will be helpful by identifying or recognizing the data which is associated in the data model. This is one of the advantage associated to the data model. So these are all the advantages associated with respect to our data model. After knowing the plus point, now you should identify what could be the disadvantages. So disadvantages here are, first thing is to develop data model, one should know the physical data stored characteristics. So you won't be having the physical data store characteristics in the beginning, because first you will develop the conceptual one, and then you will test logically, and then only you will implement it in the physical data level. You won't be getting the database which has been implemented directly so that you can visualize physically. No, first it will be conceptual, it will be tested logically, and then only you will get it into the physical data level. So if you get directly at physical data level for implementation, that will be still beneficial. And hence this is one of the drawback. Next is, this is a navigation system and it produces complex application development, because you'll be having a huge data and substantiating it, achieving relationship between the tables. It results always in a complex application development, because you should use different keys, primary keys, functional keys, you should execute, run. So it leads to a complex development, even though you have all the data recorded in a single system. And hence, it requires a huge knowledge related to the biographical truth associated to that product. So it is a little tricky and complex thing. So one should set his mind in order to evaluate the conceptual to that of the physical database. So many things come in between. So all those have to be done carefully, even though it is a complex application. But if it is done once successfully for the use of the longer run, it will be very good. But initially, it will be having some complexities until you establish successfully a data model in any organization or company or industry. Next disadvantage is, even smaller change made in the structure requires results in modifying the entire application. Right, so if you, after running physically the data model, if you feel anything has to be modified, a minor change also, the result gets modified for that entire application. So you have to scrutinize, run and check and evaluate, which will be a little bit time consuming. So this is one of the disadvantage. And you cannot do any data manipulation. You cannot use any data manipulation languages in DBMS system. Once done, it is done. You cannot manipulate anything, or you cannot use the data manipulation languages. You have to follow the SQL commands or Oracle commands, D2K forms, in order to run the DBMS system. So this is one of the disadvantages. If they ask you to just speak about the advantages and disadvantages, you can list out. If they ask you to entire process, how does a data model works, you have to write the diagram, and then you have to. Yeah, Abhishek, you want to speak anything? Abhishek? Okay, so this is related to our data model. If they ask you to explain the process, draw the diagram, explain its description, all the three categories, what are its goals and objectives. So this is the entire process data model, how it operates. Okay, so this is associated with our product structural view. I have explained it already, right? So here you can see you will be having identification of the parts. So that will be, this is the product structural view. And this is the model view. So how both are interrelated. Okay, so once you define a product component, with the database, it helps to identify the parts which has to be done. So this product structural view shows the decomposition of the levels what it has to perform. So then when you select the part, it also shows the sub-assemblies and the assemblies which has to be done. So after sub-assemblies and assemblies, you will configure the product based on the items specified over here. And if any modification has to be done, then it shows for alternative. So in this, you can specify the variance. Variance also we dealt yesterday. It could be positive variance or negative variance. Positive variance are associated with the plus points for any product. So it will specify the variance and any alternatives which are in need as per the product structure. So once that variant is expected, is accepted, then it goes for structuring of the product. So when it comes to the structuring of the product, you will define the relationship between the items which has to be manufactured and assembled. So that is related to the relationship part in our product structure. So this relationship part comes to the functional structure. We studied organ structure, synthesis structure, functional structure, and on the all together how the product structure matrix looks like. So this is a product structure matrix, how it is interrelated to our process modeling of a particular product. Okay, so then finally, once the relationship has been established, you will be having the master structure. So based on the master structure, it will be decomposed into product definition. So based on the product definition defined, you will be having the defined product structural views, which provide what are the needed views from the customer, right? What are the product definitions? Both will be interlinked in creating an required specific view of the product. So the product once generated will be bifurcated into different views. How the sales of the product is, how the purchasing